PGF to mission control. PLX-731 sample secured. En route to second helipad for extraction. Do you copy?
Good job, Agent. But I'm afraid I have some bad news. The objective of this operation has been updated. Agent Krychek and Wes have disappeared, and until they've been found, we can't allow you to leave the building. Your new objective is to complete the mission of the Epsilon team, and download all the research data on your DID. Blaze, confirm status update. Over.
New objective confirmed. On my way. Over. Sure. I'm just a war dog, after all. Sample somehow. Sandman, do you copy? I found West's body. Looks like he was shot to death. No sign of Krychek yet. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? God damn this cock-sucking storm!
Thank you.
private office of the Founder. From here, I should be able to restore system passwords.
Thank you.
Liev to Mission Control. If you can hear me, I've just restored the facility passcodes from the Matrix. I'm in the process of gathering the 731 samples and data off the server. Over. This is Liev. About time. What the hell happened? I've retrieved the 731 samples. Now I'm heading over to the server room to gather the search data. Over.
Understood. We're having trouble with the comm system. To make matters worse, this storm isn't getting any less wild, and the loads are being pushed to the limit. I don't think it'll hold for much longer. Your new rendezvous point is the main entrance, so head there. Hurry up and grab the data so we can get the hell out of here. Watch your back. Open comms for 2236. Over.
Hey, you! Drop your gun and let me see your hands! Right now!
Sorry. I thought you were one of those dead, melted thingies that killed the others.
Yeah, well, I ain't. And you almost got shot in the head, whoever you are.
You know, I'm no threat to you. My name's John. It's John Fay. I work for Aegis, in the Information Science Department. Well, mostly, in the server room. I've been hiding down there for hours, since all hell broke loose. All communications are down, and I didn't think anyone would risk their lives to actually save us.
What the hell happened to this place?
I'm not sure exactly, but I don't think it was accidental.
How do you mean?
Well, I can access anything via the server. The security system, surveillance cameras, and naturally, the personnel, files of all the Aegis employees. I've been trying to reconstruct exactly what went wrong. And actually, You'd be amazed at what somebody can achieve down here in just a few hours. Anyway, I think it's safe to say that one of our own stole some research and covered the whole up as an accident, obscuring all evidence of their damnable theft.
Huh. You don't say. I'm gonna need that fancy ID card of yours to access the server.
Well, why? Why'd you want to access the server? I thought you were actually here to rescue us.
Technically, those were your words, not mine. Sorry, bud. Orders are orders.
But what about the others? All the survivors in the building? You're not gonna let us die here.
Nah, you're right. I guess I can. I mean, especially you. Oh, what the heck. I'll lend a hand.
Evacuation sequence activated.
Back to base.
My pawn moved admirably through the AG's lab. And with just a few bad moves, the game proceeded ahead. Unfortunately, I underestimated the fierce loyalties of those no-good Hexacore players.
It was the most incredible fight I ever saw. He just grabbed the guy, bit his ear off, and spit it on the mat. How often does that happen?
During a boxing match? Never.
HQ here. We read your signal on beacon. You're less than 30 minutes from base. Acknowledge.
This is Sandman Actual. Roger your last, HQ. Commencing final approach procedures to base. Any sign of the others? Over.
Negative, Sandman Actual. Epsilon has gone out with their MIA. Special unit is being deployed to secure the site and evacuate survivors as soon as possible. Over and out.
Maybe we should have waited after all.
Not a chance. There's no way the carriers would have withstood that storm for a moment longer. Besides, I didn't come all this way to fail.
Fail? Right. You know, for a second there, I forgot how you do things, Major.
You sit there, all ladylike to keep that immaculate uniform or spick and span while real soldiers go into battle.
Too bad it has to be at the expense of real men with bona fide families. Yeah. Fucking crimson skulls, man. You're all the fucking same. I can see why you chose this boy to be your sidekick. You've both got a lot in common. For starters, just think about it. You're both cowardly little bitches that leave comrades to die.
What did you just say to me? You better watch your fucking mouth.
Knock it off, you two. Epsilon or no Epsilon, our orders stand.
He's right. You squawk way too much.
Listen carefully, Dylan. Because I won't repeat this again. I know what it's like to lose somebody and not be able to do a goddamn thing about it. But you can't go on blaming yourself. You made a judgment call on that plane. Otherwise, you'd both be dead. And I think he would have done the same in your position. Are we clear?
If you say so, Major. It's just, every time I close my eyes, I can still see him. He's burning up and screaming for me to somehow help him, and I can't.
I know, but sometimes you just gotta move forward, Let go and focus on the present moment. You cut through that storm with your fangs out. You got golden hands, kid. I'm impressed. And now that your scars are more or less healed, I'm sure you'll go back to flying solo any day now. Fuck me.
Hey, Major. You looking to lose the payload now that we're so close to base?
God damn it. Raven, take the controls. I'm gonna go check and make sure supports are secure. That storm really pushed them to the limit.
Yes, sir.
Fuck's sakes, kid. Your file says you're the real deal. Took an SR-91 from the Aurora program to hypersonic Mach 6. That's a hell of a lot more than most pilots can say. By all rights, you should be able to fly this toy with your eyes closed. You know, I pushed for you to join the Skulls, even after what happened at Dryden. Only place I want to see you falling is on the mat after our bouts. Okay, now focus and keep this bird up in the sky.
You got it, Major. I won't let you down.
This is Sam Walker. I'm out at the game tower at Hunter's Pass. Come in, over.
Keenside Police, Kenneth speaking. Go ahead, Sam.
Oh, hey, Ken. I don't want to rain on your parade, but some chopper nearly took my head off not 5 minutes ago. Do you know anything about that? Over.
Right. Sorry, Sam. Those big shots called in last night to schedule transport passing through the area. Nice exercise or something. In and out. Real hush-hush. You should be safe to go back up there.
I read you, Ken. Although next time, you know, I'd be mighty grateful for any notice. Over and out. Hey, baby, it's me. The generator. Oh, yeah. I remember to turn off the lights in the house. Otherwise, you'll have to refuel again before daybreak.
I know. Sam, I'm not sure if I'll ever get used to living out in these woods. It's just so isolated. So, why'd you call, baby? Need help booking some rest while you were coon?
Funny. You know, maybe. I'm still on duty. Listen, I was just on the radio with Ken, so I thought I'd check in on you. And I feel bad about not being able to take you to the Cherry Blossom Feast. I know how much it means to you. It's just, well, you know how the night shift works.
I know all too well. Ken, did something happen?
No, nothing to worry about. I just had a near miss in the tower involving some bozo in a helicopter. And hold on a second. Shit, I can't find my meds. I must have dropped him when that chopper went past. God only knows where they ended up.
That's not good, Sam. You know you need those for...
Don't start that again. I'm fine. I can manage it. I've been living with this for a long time now.
Sam, you know what happened the last time you didn't take them?
How could I forget? With you constantly reminding me. Listen, I gotta go, baby, okay? Don't worry about a thing. It's just a few more hours. Go to bed and get some rest. I'll be home in the morning.
I love you.
I can manage it. I can manage it. Just like last time.
Major! What's going on here?
David, help me, please.
Go through, Lee. Put the weapon down.
No fucking way.
Talk to me, sir. What the hell is going on?
Pollux. He broke a vial in my face.
Enough chatter. Step away from him right now.
God damn you, Lee.
Well, well. Who would have thought? Tonight's the night that you finally fail a mission. Lo and behold, the great Sandman. Isn't as great after all, is he? And who would have thought? Tonight's also the night when you die. You know, for what it's worth, I can honestly say, I had the real displeasure of serving under you, Major. Oh, and don't worry. I'll take care of these. Farewell. What? Son of a bitch! Oh, shit, didn't see that coming.
Has already invaded the entire town. The mask will not hold up for long. I have to find a place to take refuge. Seems to be the ideal place to take cover.